everybody. This is Flavor Flores coming to you from the National Science Teachers Association Convention in San Francisco. We're here. This is just a little mini exhibit displaying just some of the things that we've got out here, some of our favorite flavors. Of course, we all know Red Hots come from this wonderful cinnamon coming from Indonesia, smelling sweet and warm and smoky. It's great stuff. Tree bark, in case you didn't know. And then, of course, this is the one that everybody has been asking about all weekend long. This is where gummy bears have been traditionally derived. This is Chondrus crispus, Irish moss seaweed. And if you can feel this, it feels very dense, very rubbery. The substance that comes out of this stuff is carrageenan. And you might recognize that word carrageenan from a number of ingredients lists, things like toothpaste, dog food, for instance, lunch meat, things of that nature. And this is what gives gummies their shape, and that really squishy texture is when this stuff is boiled, it becomes very jelly-like, and it retains whatever shape it is as it cools down.
Hi, my name is Miss Winnie. I'm a 4th through 8th grade science teacher at St. Martin's School in Sunnyvale, California. And this program will be wonderful for my 4th and 5th grade students. We learn about plants, and they could use it to go on in the computer lab and teach them the different parts of the plants and then let them go. It's a fun activity for them to do, and just let them each week do different activities, and they can do it from home as well. So I'm really excited to put it into my classroom.
Well, what I found the most interesting with this site is the fact that, first of all, it's free, which is always excellent for teachers.
Yes.
And then beyond that, it's a resource. I'm an agri-science teacher, and I teach plant science. And I'm trying to expand the knowledge of younger students in my school district about plant science, because we don't offer that curriculum. And I've been trying to work with some of our science teachers in our middle schools to do that. And it's created a lot of work for me, but I just haven't found the time to do it. And simply now what I can do with this resource is just send this link to those teachers that they can use in their classrooms, and now I've spread it exponentially with me only giving them one simple link, and my job has been made much easier.
Okay.